Hi guys, welcome back. So in the previous one, we created the form and checked for whether the input is present or not. That's not quite enough for validation. I think there is more scope for improvement here. So let's say somebody enters a string here and it's not an email. We should be able to tell, we should throw an error saying it's not a valid email. So we can do that using, maybe we can do it on our own using regex on the backend on the server file, or we can use a third party validator like yup, zod or something. So in this one, I'm gonna do the same. I'm gonna use yup, which is quite simple. The way we can use that is just install yup first, npm install as a dev dependency. Yep. So once that is happening, we'll go here and we'll pick this up. So this is required for building a schema. I'll tell you what it is. Now we can import it here. If you look at this, getting started section, it says it's a schema, right? So we build a schema. We check whether our values or user input values passes these or not. So I'll just call this, I'll make this a constant. Now, wherever possible, use constant. Contact form schema, or you can call anything. So name is there, string and required is correct. It should be a string, it is required. Now email is there, string and email, it is also required. Required. These are not there. We have something called message, and it is a string, it is required. So what happens here is when it validates, it checks whether it is, you know, present or not. If we mention as required, it should be present, otherwise it throws an error. Now these things we built last time may not be required now. Okay, so how do we validate? So here using this. Okay, so let me go through that. Wait, fetch user, they are fetching it from somewhere, but we have it already. User schema, so it's contact schema. So I'll just call this result. Validate, what should it validate? It's the name. I'm putting these here, mail and message. So name, email, message. Okay. Yeah, this should be it. Now there is a article here or recipe about how to do it. They have put a try catch block here inside where they validate. That may be required here. The reason being, it might throw an error and break the entire server. So let's see if that happens. So yeah, it already did. It said internal server error, but I think it didn't break anything. Okay, so let me try to console log the result. So submit. Okay, it is breaking now. Message is required field and breaks. Now let's put this in a try catch block and test the same thing. Whatever you need to be passed, put it in try block. I'll have a this here. I'll copy the same thing to see the error. Now let's try the same thing. What? Okay, it passed because, I have to put this return also in here. So otherwise it will always pass. So yeah, we submit, I go to the server and it says validation error, message is required field. Now it is only showing message. I want all, maybe it is only showing the last one, I don't know. So there is something called abort early false. So I'll use that. This is because, you know, whenever it sees one error message, it shouldn't stop there. It should throw error for all of them. Let me try this again. And yes, so in errors, we see all the fields. Before it wasn't, I think. It was only telling message. But here, it gave me all of this. Now I want to pick this up as a as an object. Now there is a way of doing that in it is mentioned here as well. So we are going to the try catch block. We are going to the error block here. Once we get the error, we can use it to we can actually return. So I can actually have this. So you can copy this from my repo also. Do error because that is what we get. Error dot inner reduce. So what it does is, if I console that, I don't have to console. I'm actually consoling the form, right? So you'll see it. Now here, if I open the console and submit, so this is what it does. Gives me properly what the error message is, and it is taking that as value. So which shouldn't have happened. We shouldn't return it directly. So let's go back. We will not return that. We'll return something else. So we'll return, or we will do const errors equals all this, and I will return errors. Okay, so this way it won't do that. Okay, so I'm getting errors and all these fields. Okay, now along with errors, I might want, let's say I enter this, I'm not getting the, you know, name and everything, right? Along with errors, I'll send name, email. These are the input values message. So don't pass password here. You know, you should be passing it back. But yes, so once that is done, I think it should work as expected. Yeah. Right. Some weird thing happening. Now I know why this is happening. This is because of enhance. We will have to improve it. I'll tell you that in the later at a later stage, but right now I'm gonna remove that and see if everything works as expected. So I enter some message and submit, and it's submitted. Refresh. I missed the name. I enter something here and message. Name is required. Now I enter wrong. I mean, it's not an email, and do it. It is not. It is throwing an error. Okay, what is it? Email must be a valid email. Okay, good. So it is working as expected. So we are getting the errors as well. Now here we have to make some changes. So since we are getting errors, we can do form instead of this, we can do form dot errors. Sorry, errors dot this is one name, right? So same thing can be done for others. Like here it is email, and similarly here it is message. Okay, so this is good. Also, so that is why we did this function. So this function where it reduces the error message, finds the error message array, and does it in an object, use it in an object. Very useful. So I'll tell you why. Below input, we'll be showing the input errors. So how do we do that? We have if this error, then show that error. And we close this. Okay. I'll also have a class of red maybe, because I want the text to be red because it's an error. Now I go here top red, make the color red, right? Now if name is missing, it will throw that error. So let me miss the name here, submit. Something is wrong. Errors, name is missing. Oh, okay. Did I do it everywhere? Yeah. Let me find all that. Okay, yeah. So now you see it. Name is missing. So I will copy this and use it below every input. This is email. And this is message. So this won't be shown if everything goes right or if things are correct. Now if email is missing, then it shows a different error. Email is a required field. Now names usually have at least two characters, right? So that also we can check here. If you look at the schema, name is a string. We have something called min. We'll have two. If it's like, you know, it's not two characters, then it will throw an error A. Let's say I enter A and submit. Must be at least two characters, right? It generates those messages already. Or you can also generate it. So you can just say too short here. And this message will be shown. So let's say A, submit, too short. So you can customize those messages. Even in required, if you enter something like name, anonymous, or we only accept name users or something. A weird kind of error message. You submit, that shows up here. So you can customize however you want it. This is going to be very useful in case you want to show custom error messages and validate them before you even submit. Okay, so that I think did it. But if you observe, we are actually doing a refresh, right? We removed use enhance for this to work. But if you're using use enhance, you will have to be a little careful about how it's gonna function, because it might break it. There is something called apply action which you can use inside here. I'll tell you how. So you don't need to know exactly what it does, but apply action applies the action once the submission happens. So which may not happen here. The form may not update properly, so we return an asynchronous function. Here we'll have that result and also update, I think. Not quite sure, but yeah. And here we can get apply action here, and we do await apply action, and result is the one we pass. Update is not even required, I think. Now, if you are doing this, everything should work as usual without refresh. So let's say I enter a short name. Yeah, it's happening. And it doesn't doesn't remove it. It lets you change it. So let's say I entered something I missed out at. Maybe I entered something as 2. Missed out shift there. So it tells me that and doesn't remove it. So, and if everything is successful, form still submits without refreshing. So this was it, guys. So you can also use, instead of YAP, you can also use Zard. Both are pretty similar. This is about validating user input. So hit thumbs up if you liked it. And also subscribe to see more of these videos.